That's how it was up until 10 minutes after noon, December 2nd, 1919, when W.P. Ridley and W.A. Dale purchased my Rattle and Snap for $77,800. Dazel Barry Whitehurst, known for his productive farming methods, was hired on as foreman. Dazel's young son, Herman, was in charge of counting the mules, which was becoming a prominent source of income. Lambs and wool were sold to pay the taxes, and the care of the sheep was entrusted to Esau, a gentle black giant who served as Mr. Whitehurst's right-hand man and was noted throughout Murray County because of his method of shaving. You see, Esau would cover his face with coal oil and then singe his stubby beard with a lighted torch. Needless to say, Esau made local history when gasoline was introduced to the farm. Esau, being the good man that he was, drew his full monthly pay while he was recovering from his accident. His pay consisted of 16 pounds of bacon, 24 pounds of flour, 48 pounds of meal, and $5 cash. Now, the Whitehurst had an added chore. The dust blowing into Middle Tennessee from the Oklahoma dust storms settled in and around the house and became a real problem. Almost daily, new mops had to be made from corn shucks to keep the floor clean. However, the newly added minerals that settled on the fields seemed to enhance the growth of Tennessee red cob corn. After Dazel's death in 1934, you could hear Herman recounting his days at the mansion.